Vice Chairman of CII Chandigarh. Hi, Mr. Virk.
Hello, Ms. Sarvjeet.
I'm so happy to have you here. Taking our conversation forward from how the ecosystem in Chandigarh can be developed, I want to know from you, what do you think is the most exciting about startups mushrooming in tier 2 cities? How do you think these startups can be handheld by organizations such as CII, and what promise do these startups really hold?
See, as the word itself says, startup, you know, they are the grooming buds who obviously have an idea. They think that this is something which they want to do it, probably sacrificing something, which is could be a job or which could be their present ecosystem. What we have seen is that tier 3 city, predominantly Chandigarh and Tri-City, has really been a platform for a lot of such activities. We have a decent number of incubators. We also have CREC, which is an industry academia platform where, you know, we try to interact with students at the school level to make them aware as to where the corporate world is or how do we really help them understand their idea and give the appropriate inputs to channelize their thoughts, because sometimes a tweak itself could create a product to a more scalable model or revolutionary than what the thoughts are initially. Having said that, you know, CII itself, you know, we try to interact a lot with the academia side. We also interact with the startups community itself to understand and then eventually do the best. So what really startups want right now is predominantly not funding, I'll be honest to you. I think their idea is first to reassure that their idea is correct. Because what we have seen over a period of time is that people try to do something more traditional or something which they feel will eventually be more scalable. The first and paramount important is to validate their idea, which will eventually help them to get to the next level. So as a CII, we also try to interact with the colleges, even with the startups. We also do events in Tri-City to interact and give them a booster to give them a positive feedback. That is where, you know, we have been off lately very involved with the startup community.
Do you think India has smart entrepreneurs?
We can start naming them, I'm sure. And you know, there is lot more which is happening. So I think besides the whole idea of raising capital, the innovation is coming into picture as well. So we can't just purely believe because a company A has a valuation of certain billion dollars, it has a value to it. I think that innovation itself is coming. The convenience is what, you know, I keep referring back. When we are able to offer that back to the consumer, it automatically becomes a mass product.
To give startups two tips, what would be your tips for starting up and innovating, like you said?
Good question. So even during the session, I was just talking about the ABCD of startup. So I said A has to be the affordability. The product needs to be affordable to the consumer. B is the barriers. Unless we identify that what are our barriers now or in future, entry as a business or exit, it is very difficult to scale it up. It could be technology as well. It could be scalable because of it needs a lot of manpower. So we need to identify that. Third C is the convenience. Unless the product is very simple and convenient, typically consumer might change their mind. And lastly, as I say, D is digital disruption. Unless we try to do more disruptive by using technology, as you rightly said, IoT, AI, machine learning, data, it is going to be a product which is good, but in order to be a unicorn, it has to be digitally driven, technology.
The realities of India.
The reality of India. I mean, I think we have really made a good progress in the last few years, and there is a lot more which is on the table, and the government is supporting it. And as the CII, we said, you know, we also do a lot of introspection as to what areas to identify and promote. And importantly, the founders itself are more passionate. Since the ecosystem is supporting, so there are more willingness to take risk, and which eventually drives the country.